Hi everybody, welcome to our Golfalot channel. My name is Sophie Walker and today we are going to look at launch monitors. Now, 15 years ago, maybe even 20, when the laser came out for yardages, I thought that would change the game and everybody would have one. And I think we've seen that with GPS watches and laser. When launch monitors came out, that revolutionized the professional game. Once again, I thought everybody's gonna have one of these. And they do. You look on a range at a PGA Tour event or an LPGA event, and everybody has a launch monitor behind them. You don't see it in amateur game. Why? Because they're the best part of 20 grand, these launch monitors. And people are investing in themselves because they're a business and they have to go on the golf course to earn money. How can an amateur improve their game? That's a lot of money to invest in, isn't it? This might be the answer. FlightScope Mevo Plus is just under £2,000. Yes, it's still expensive, but there's so much on offer here. Does it compete against the big boys? Before I start, can you please like this video? You are gonna like it, so just do it early, and then subscribe to our Golfalot channel so you don't miss out on any of our content. Now, FlightScope have a large launch monitor, which is similar in size to Trackman. It has a Mevo, which is small, very small, like that big. And now this is the Mevo Plus. It's still pretty small. Like that is definitely travel size and not too heavy. I mean, bottle of water maybe in your golf bag, absolutely fine. So I have charging cables. I've got the FlightScope here. Let's see. Probably set it up like that, but we'll look at that in a minute. Nice case. Oh, dots. Some people don't like dots, but let me see. Oh, this is just for indoor use. Okay, so dots on the golf ball. A couple of clips. Oh, and a quick start guide. So I think I'm gonna have to download a few apps and then I assume maybe link it via Bluetooth or Wi-Fi. But yeah, very small, pretty dinky. Travel-like, let's pair it up to my iPad. I said you need to download the app. It's FS Golf, so FlightScope Golf. You can use Android or Apple devices. Download that one, log in. So you need an email account, create a password. Make sure you write down the password because hey, I'm one of you. I forget them all the time. And then you need to pair the FlightScope to the app. So once everything's logged in, you click at the top of your screen and it'll say you've got to scan a QR code. Well, this QR code is on the back of the FlightScope. So I'll turn the FlightScope on. Just hold that button down there. A couple of beeps and it's ready to go. There we go. So it's changed now, green at the top of my screen. It says it's connected. See there, top right. Connected. Just a reminder, when I set up my login, I needed Wi-Fi to set up my username and password. So bear that in mind. Get everything set up kind of at home or in your office with your Wi-Fi before you're going to take it to the range. Okay, looks like I'm pretty much set up. Start new session. Short indoor, indoor or outdoor. So I think this is just regular indoor. It tells me where I need to set up the radar, so I'll have a look at that. So 2.4 meters, similar to what I do with Trackman. Start session, and put this on the ground. That took about 5 minutes, but remember I had to create a new account, so it'll be faster than that once you get started. FlightScope's 2.4 meters away, 8 feet. I've got my iPad on show today. This is just so it looks pretty at the moment, and we'll probably use it later because, as you can guess, we're going to compare it against the Trackman 4. Very similar layout with the driving range and the different dials at the bottom, the tiles I think they're called. So yeah, all looks pretty easy enough. 7 iron I've clicked. Something that you just got to get used to, just playing around of what clubs you want and what type of numbers you want. I've just gone with as much as possible on here at the moment. Put the dots on the balls also, because it's indoor. Want to get it as good as we can. let's put this down here. That was quick, wasn't it? It was literally as soon as I hit it. On 28, first 7 iron of the day, so get that. Spin rate 6.2, that sounds about right. Straight down the middle. It's obviously really accurate, this flight's going. Okay. Wow, I can't believe how quick that feedback was. Agreed, caught that a bit toey, so it didn't go quite as far. That one felt a touch left. Yeah, that it went left. So it went left, so it went further. Hitting zone. Now, sometimes with the Trackman, I get it in the wrong spot, although it is pretty wide. I can mess it up. So I've been hitting from around here, which is bang in line with the Mevo Plus. So I'm going to move the ball outside that line. But I still caught it here. Spin numbers and everything still seemed fine. It says it's gone left, and actually it says it started left of the white target line. So obviously target line is in line with this flight scope and it's moved to here. So that could be why, but it's picked it all up. Now when you're off a mat, it doesn't really matter because you're always going to hit from the same spot. Imagine when you're on the practice ground and you've got grass, you're going to have to start moving around a lot. And with the quad, it's quite easy. You just get the stick out and line it around. With Trackman, it takes a little bit more fiddling around. But with the Mevo Plus, because it is so small, I think it's going to be a lot easier to, well, travel with it for one and move it as well. But that's good to know. It's still picked up within nearly a club length. Right, I'm going to start trying to shape this 7-iron, see how well it picks up. So a couple of fades. Yeah, that one moved. Right, gonna hit a draw now. Yeah, picks them all up nicely. It's quick, isn't it, when it says it's ready. It doesn't take time to settle. You get the numbers straight away. There's no pause to it. So you get the numbers straight away and it's getting ready for the next shot straight away. So if you are a rapid fire practicer, and this FlightScope Mevo Plus is perfect for you. So you know when you go to the driving range with your mate and you're always recording your golf swing to send to your coach or to stick it on social media if you're that type of person. Trust me, Tiger Woods is the only one we really care about. But you can record your swing, you can get all the data for it, all the lines and everything you can draw on it. It's a really good feature and it's pretty quick. Check this out. Bit left. So that will then save. You can compare it against your other swings. As I say, you can send it on, but the fact that it's there so quickly afterwards, you can do a bit of analysis. And for coaches, if you're out on the practice ground, it's a really easy way to just send swings through to your pupils. Nice extra there. I think a lot of companies are doing it, but the fact that this FlightScope does it so easily and so quickly, big bonus for me. Now, this is the part of the video that you have all been looking forward to, and me too. 20 grand Trackman forecast about FlightScope Mevo Plus, £2,000. Let's compare the two. Ten shots using Trackman against FlightScope. Now I could set that one shot up using both devices, which was pretty cool. Just bear in mind with the FlightScope, it's got to be at a good angle. That caught me out. You can also change the weather, which is pretty cool. So I made sure that I was on 25 degrees at sea level on both of them, because there was no way I was going outside in the Manchester weather this time of year. So the findings. Remember, Trackman is the best part of 20 grand. FlightScope is just under £2,000. So you're expecting to see 18 grand worth of difference in the results? I am. What have I found? average carry 209.6 with the FlightScope, and average carry with the Trackman is 211.7, so what, 2 yards. Then we look into club speed. Club speed's faster with the FlightScope by a couple of mile an hour, so it's 92.9 against 90.9. I'm not as bothered about club speed, I've got to say. I think if you haven't got the launch monitor right in front of you, as in at the ball, I do think the club data is not quite as good as normal. So club speed, not too worried about. It's all about the ball for me on this one. Ball speed, that's the important one. 133.6 FlightScope. And if we look at it on Trackman, it's 132.5. I mean, that is nothing. Spin. Spin indoor can be a little inconsistent at the best of times. Now, with FlightScope, you've got that silver dot that you can put on the ball. I would encourage you to do that. Make sure the dot faces the target, so away from the FlightScope or the Mevo Plus in our case, to get the better spin numbers. So average spin with the FlightScope, 2,682 RPM. It's 2,576 with the Trackman. And if you look at my last tee shot, this is the kind of one that I really want to do the comparison. So FlightScope carry, 215 yards. Trackman, 212 yards. Spin rate, 1979. So low spin. It was once again low spin with the Trackman at 1979. Exactly the same. Smash factor, 1.46 with FlightScope Mevo Plus, 1.47. Launch angles, 14.1 against 13.3. There's really very little in this shot. I really enjoyed the fact that I could test it exactly against that same shot. The only significant difference I've seen is an average in club speed, which is greater in the Mevo, and the total in the Mevo. So the total distance, the carry is much of a muchness. So the Mevo said I've averaged 217.7 and the Trackman has said 237.2. Now, I think I could go into my settings and have a look at how firm the ground is there, which I didn't do. So for me, all about carry in this case, as we are indoor testing, there's not much in it. There really isn't. Even the shapes of the shots were so close together. And we're putting Trackman as the benchmark, Trackman 4, because that's what we use at Golfalot. Trackman and Foresight are seen as the top bracket of launch monitors. If you say to anybody Trackman, most people know who it is. I mentioned FlightScope to somebody that works at the car dealership earlier and he had no idea what it was. So in terms of that, that's why we're comparing it. We're not saying Trackman is perfect. It's going to be within a couple here or there in terms of yards, even against other Trackmans. But I've got to say, indoor testing, I was mightily impressed with this FlightScope. One of my most positive verdicts with the Golfalot channel with this FlightScope, because I've used FlightScope in the past, maybe 4 or 5 years ago when I was on tour, looking to buy a launch monitor, spoke to them, had a quick go with the Mevo, and there was a few things that I wasn't happy with. Be it with the normal FlightScope, switching from left-handed to right-handed, you had to move the thing. Not in the case anymore. This can go left-handed, right-handed perfectly well. There's some other really good stuff with it. The size. Okay, so this is the next up from the normal Mevo. So this is the Mevo Plus. However, in terms of weight, it weighs less than a bottle of Evian, sponsor me. Yeah, bottle of water. So only a pound, okay? So that is so much easier just to whack in your golf bag or in your travel bag if you're going abroad with it, driving ranges, etc. The small compact size is an advantage over the likes of Trackman and Foresight. They don't offer a mini version, but FlightScope do. So that is where they differentiate themselves. I also thought that the feedback was accurate and was quick. Literally, as soon as I hit the ball, the lady was like 138 yards, which can be turned off if it's slightly annoying. But that was good. I thought that sometimes you think, oh, I'm going to have to wait for that. Didn't happen. The video in, brilliant. The fact that you can share that obviously to social media or to your coach very quickly and easy to use. If you go to your driving range with your mate, they can record you and send it off and save it. That's good. 17 practice ranges. There's a lot of ranges for you to try. Hitting areas. One time out of a whole day of testing with this FlightScope Mevo Plus did we not catch a bit of data. So that was good. I do think the silver dots on the balls are key. Make sure you got them in the right position, because then the data becomes really quite intense and correct. Also, I had the wrong setting on. I had the weather outside, so it was 1 degree, so my ball wasn't flying too far. Changed that and everything was fine. I just think in general with these pieces of equipment, it's very human error, which is the problem with it. So it's the input that we put in. So make sure that you have a play with it and see what you can do, because there is loads more that I could have done today. Like, there's a skills app. So just like Trackman with their combined, you can do that with FlightScope. There's also golf courses. There is only 5 of them. The battery life is 60 to 90 minutes, which is a practice session. Just make sure you keep it on charge if you're going out and about on the golf course or on the driving range. But obviously, if you've got a home simulator and you're very lucky, you'll be absolutely fine with that. Yeah, and the QR code, the scanning of the QR code to get this device linked with this iPad. It didn't work first time. It worked second, third, fourth, fifth. It can be a bit frustrating, but it did go eventually. So it's just getting used to that, I suppose. I think size-wise is fantastic. That is the biggest thing for me. It was almost the travel size to it, and then does the data work? Because it's all right being really small and portable, but what happens if it's nothing like all the other manufacturers? And it is. It's very much comparable against the Trackman and the Foresights. What type of golfer should use this FlightScope Mevo Plus? Now, at just under £2,000, that's expensive, okay? But comparing it to other companies, it's reasonably cheap. But I still say you've got to be quite a committed golfer, committed to improving your game and understanding these yardages as well, because there's a lot, sorry, not just yardages, numbers in general. There's a lot to delve into. So if you're somebody that takes golf lessons online and sends data through to your coach, this is perfect for you because it, as I say, it stacks up against all other pieces of software. I would recommend this as also to a professional golfer that might not be able to afford a Trackman. That would have been me back in the day. I never bought a Foresight or a Trackman. I kept saying to myself, I should, and I just couldn't part with that amount of money. I did test the Mevo and I really wanted it. It was like £500, but it didn't stack up. If this would have been available 5 or 6 years ago, I would have purchased it. So you're looking at that Challenge Tour, LET, Professional or Mini Tour. You can take this everywhere with you. I mean, just like you have your iPad, you have your FlightScope, put it in your rucksack and you can travel the world with it. And also if you're a coach that is looking to develop your coaching regime and invest in some technology, and that initial £20,000, that's a lot, isn't it? It's going to take a good year or so of coaching to get that back. This will be instant feedback in terms of data and with your lessons, because I've got to say, I am incredibly impressed with what data has come out of this FlightScope compared to what I would class as the benchmark of Trackman. It's up there, it really is. And we will be using this outside on a lot more of our videos. The best portable launch monitor I've ever tested. If you've liked this video, please click the like button, subscribe to our Golfalot YouTube channel. There's some good stuff coming up. I'll do a written review for golfalot.com so you can give it a read on there. Thanks for watching. You'll see this a lot more in our videos, and I'll see you all again soon.